I'm Chaplain Simpson from Malmstrom Air Force Base, and I want to share with you a message regarding our comprehensive Airman Fitness Part 2 up to on mental fitness. Today, we're just trying to normalize things. It's easy to get out of whack during this COVID-19. But as we try to normalize, we need to be careful that we don't make bad decisions and create bad habits. I talked about that in a previous video. That's why we need to help each other. We need to help strengthen each other and strengthen our mental fitness pillar. As I was talking with Master Sergeant Abear the other day, our chapel superintendent, he reminded me of the difference between the spiritual and the mental pillar. The spiritual has to do with things that we cannot control. And the mental are things that we can control. In our mental pillar, we need to accept ourselves for who we are. We can't change who we are. That's out of our control. But we can control accepting who we are. We can also control being a better version of ourselves. Meaning, what are you doing to improve you? Not change you, but improve you. I have a tendency to be a perfectionist, which is an oxymoron because a human cannot be perfect. So this creates frustration and hopelessness because I want to be perfect and make everything else around me perfect. My spiritual fitness helps me with that because I learn how to deal with what I cannot control. But what can I control? I remember one of my basic chaplain course instructors who talked to me about something that really resonated with him when someone shared it with him. And he said that it's important not to worry about being the best at something, but rather doing your best. So I realized that there's a lot of wisdom in that. There's actually a lot of common sense to that because we cannot be more than our potential allows. Having said that, I am very competitive. I appreciate trying to outdo someone else. It helps me be or bring out the best in me. But I balance that with accepting where I end up and appreciating the opportunities that I do have. So I want to leave you with some tips taken from the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services on how to support mental health during this COVID-19 pandemic. So first thing is keep things in perspective. Limit how much time you spend reading and watching news on the outbreak and keep a positive outlook on things. Read things that are factual. Get the facts. Find people and resources that you can depend on for accurate health information, such as your local health department or government agency. Keep yourself healthy. Eat healthy foods and drink water. Avoid excessive amount of alcohol. Do not avoid tobacco and illegal drugs. Drugs and alcohol do not normalize anything, but rather they poison your mental health. So get enough sleep, exercise. The last thing they mention is use practical ways to relax. Practice meditation, your hobbies, take time off to relax, and pace yourself between stressful activities. But I want to add just a couple more things. I think it's important to maintain a schedule during this time because that can get out of whack. And so we're used to a schedule at school and work. So maintain some sort of schedule. Be intentional about your when you work and when you take breaks and your family time, when you research. Schedule and volunteering time. Time limits on your social media. So this will prevent idleness, boredom, and just getting into trouble. Second thing is monitor social media use. Set time limits on that. Don't click on links and pictures and videos that have unknown resources or that can tempt you or waste your time. Plug into a positive online group that might look like a Bible study. It might just look like a check-in group that you might create with some people, but just some place that you can go online, connect with people, talk about some relevant things, maybe share some things to help you get a positive outlook. And then the last thing is, I just think of the Spark Tank that the Air Force Association hosts. I haven't heard much on that since this all started. I haven't really been involved, but I remember seeing a video on Facebook, and that was back in February. But I think something like that, if we continue to do things that challenge our mind, if there's a way to continue to doing that online, I think it'd be very helpful. So for more information on how the Malmstrom Air Force Base Mental Health Clinic is supporting airmen during this time, you can call 731-4451. And please remember, in order to manage social distancing and scheduling, please call ahead before you come in. Remember, all four pillars interact or tie into each other. So you need to work on all four in order to become stronger, become more well-rounded, and better prepared for any challenge that comes your way. And don't forget, we're in this together. Stay tuned for the following messages on spiritual fitness pillar and others that are to come on comprehensive Airman fitness. Thank you and have a blessed day. It's a beautiful day.